Dear students, good morning to all. Today we will discuss about the topic cross multiplication method. The substitution and elimination methods involves many arithmetic operations, but in this method we utilize the coefficient of x and y and constant term. In this method we use this format: b1 b2 c1 c2 a1 a2 b1 b2. In middle of this, we write the xy1. Listen, students. In cross method, we use x divided by b1 into c2, b1 into c2 minus b2 minus c1 is equal to y divided by c1 a2. First we multiply this side c1. A2, this diagonal only we want to multiply. C1 A2 minus of C2 A1 is equal to 1 divided by A1 B2 minus of A2 B1. Is that x divided by B1 C2 minus B2 C1. Is that x divided by B1 C2 minus of B2 C1. Is equal to y divided by c1 a2 minus of c2 a1. So this side we have to put a minus of, okay? Then a1 divided by a1 b2 minus of b1 a2, okay? And so listen, students, now we see the exercise 3.13. solve the cross multiplication method. The given sum is 8x minus 3y is equal to 12 and 5x is equal to 2y plus 7. Now we have to find the solution. First, we have to write the standard form of equation. So listen, 8x minus 3y minus 12 is equal to 0. In equation, x and x coefficient and y coefficient and constant term. First you write the x term, y term, and last one we write the constant term. So given equation becomes 8x minus 3y minus 12 is equal to 0. The second equation is given 5x is equal to 2y plus 7. So 2y plus 7 comes in LHS side. It becomes 5x minus 2y minus 7 is equal to 0. Okay. Then what is A1? X coefficient. In first equation, x coefficient is A1. So A1 is equal to 8. Next, y coefficient is B. So B1. In first equation means we write the B1. B1 is equal to minus 3. And C1 is equal to constant term of first equation. So minus 12. Yeah, in second equation, A2, in second equation, so we write to A2. A2 is equal to 5 and B2 is equal to minus 2, C2 is equal to minus 7. Here, we write the cross multiplication method. B1, B2. I told column wise, B1, B2, C1, C2, A1, A2, B1, B2. So first and last column B1, B2. Okay. Now we write the B1. What is the coefficient of y in first equation? Minus 3. Minus 3, C1 is minus 12, A1 is 8, B1 is minus 3. And B2 is minus 2, C2 is 7, A2 is 5, B2 is minus 2. Okay. Are you understand, students? B1 is coefficient of y in first equation. B2 is coefficient of y in second equation. C1 is the constant term of first equation. C2 is the constant term of second equation. A1 is the coefficient of x in first equation. A2 is coefficient of x in second equation. Okay. So first we multiply the minus 3 minus 7, x divided by minus 3 minus 7 is equal to 21, and the this side may we write the minus minus of this. So minus 2 into minus 12 plus 24. The formula have minus. So 1 minus. So minus 24 is equal to y divided by minus 12 into 5 minus 60 minus 7 into 8 minus 56. The formula have 1 minus. So minus into minus plus 56 is equal to 1 divided by 8 into 2, 8 into minus 2 minus 16 and 5 into minus 3 minus 15. The formula have 1 minus, so plus 15. Listen students, now we simplify the denominator. X divided by minus 3 is equal to y divided by minus 4 is equal to 1 divided by 16 minus 16 plus 15 minus 1. So x divided by minus 3 is equal to y divided by minus 4 is equal to 1 divided by minus 1. Here we mention the first term is the first one and second term is the second one. Third one is the third one. Comparing 1 and 2, we get x divided by minus 3 is equal to 1 divided by minus 1. Now we use the cross multiplication. Cross multiplication, then we get minus x is equal to minus 3. Listen, minus x is equal to minus 3. Here we cancel the minus in both sides. Then we get x is equal to 3. Comparing 2 and 3, then we get y divided by minus 4 is equal to 1 divided by minus 1. Therefore, minus y is equal to minus 4. Here also we cancel the minus sign in both sides. Then we get y is equal to 4. Therefore, the solution is 3, 4. So, x value is 3 and y value is 4.